Hey friends, in today's video we'll be talking about the marketing lessons we can take away from one of the most popular and widely successful TV series of 2021. If you don't know what I'm talking about, I'm referring to the Korean drama and horror series called Squid Game. The show launched in mid-September, and as of last week of me filming this video, the show already had 111 million fans around the world. It has also created a $900 million impact value, which is a metric that apparently Netflix assesses when they look at the performance of shows. And this is insane considering that there was only a spend of $21.4 million in the filming of the series. So if you're a regular on the channel, you might be thinking this isn't a typical video that Elif makes on the channel, but hear me out. After binge watching the 9 episodes of the series, what attracted my attention was that I started to see this everywhere. I started to see Squid Game news, trends in the social media, and it was all of a sudden going viral, and it was just contributing to the success of the series. But as a marketer, when I watch anything, I usually tend to take away some marketing lessons from the brand, the series itself, sometimes from the storyline itself. You are always able to take away something, and I tend to just instinctively put on my marketer glasses and look at it from a brand success perspective and what have they been doing well. But in the case for Squid Game, it became such a success story. It was all over the news, blogs, social media outlets, everywhere. That, and to add to that, brands were announcing that they were working on Squid Game merchandise. People were looking for Squid Game costumes for Halloween. Mr. Beast announced that he will recreate Squid Game in real life if people give his post enough likes. And the final news I saw was that you could actually play the Squid Game in real life at Dubai Expo this year. And when I put everything together, I found myself taking notes of the lessons that we could take away from this brand success. If you haven't watched the show and you hate spoilers, don't worry, because I'm not going to give any spoilers, because I won't be talking about the show or the story itself. But if you have no idea what I'm talking about so far, I'm just going to give you a quick summary of what the topic is about. So basically in the series, we see people who are seriously in depth and who are convinced to join a tournament to play child games, and the winner is going to have a huge cash prize. Soon enough though, they realize that those childish games that seem so naive in the beginning are actually deadly, and they are killed unless they are the winner of the game. So their only chance of survival is if they win the game. It's a dystopian story, and I personally found it to be disturbing and violent. And frankly speaking, I also find it very disturbing that people are purchasing costumes of the killers in the show for Halloween. I don't know, yeah, I mean, it makes sense in the context of Halloween, I guess, but people paying to play the game in real life that was a deadly game in the series, I don't know. I personally find it disturbing, but I'll keep the commentary to myself. If you want to share anything, put them in the comments below, and let's get to the marketing lessons that we can take away from this success. First thing to take away is that a great story is unbeatable. The story doesn't really end when the show ends, so it mentally keeps you hanging in this show, and you want to have people around you to talk about it. So you want your network and friends to have also watched it so that you can talk about the show, and you potentially think of alternative endings or what could happen afterwards, or that if you missed anything while you were watching the show and all of that. So you're basically stuck in the story for a little longer. The story is disturbing, terrifying, and it's also a solid criticism of what societies are experiencing in real life. So you find yourself resonating with the story, thinking about where we actually see this, and you kind of find the metaphors in the story and you apply it to what is happening in our world right now in different societies. So you find yourself thinking about that and kind of like, I guess, resonating and finding a piece of yourself in this story, or at least resonating with the criticism that the series is making. So what's the marketing takeaway here? Use more stories in your campaigns and leave some space for your audience to think about that story. Maybe find an alternative ending and motivate them to continue the conversation outside of your campaign. So don't leave the communication just limited to the campaign message and themselves, but have them like or encourage them some way with your story to move the conversation outside as well. So basically what that means is to give them a story that they want to talk about even after coming across your brand, and a story that they want to talk about with their friends and network. Secondly, using basic human emotions. Emotions are the primary level that make up stories. They're universal and they speak to everyone. It removes cultural barriers. So what I read about this show was that they were expecting a success in Korea, but they weren't expecting this show to be widely successful everywhere else. And I think the main reason for that is because the show uses emotions and you can resonate with what the characters are going through. Addressing emotions removes cultural barriers. And what I read about this show is that they were expecting a success in Korea, but now it's also top charts in US and everywhere else as well. So emotions remove cultural barriers, and I want you to let that sink in for a moment. Within Squid Game, you find yourself drawn to this story and you find yourself rooting for the characters, feeling similar to what they felt. The marketing takeaway is for you to remember that buying decisions are based on emotions. We buy something because we want to feel a certain way, not because the product is very high quality. We want that quality product because it's going to make us feel a certain way. So the lesson is use more emotions in your copywriting and your campaigns. Thirdly, word of mouth beats any other form of marketing, especially paid marketing. So many people are talking about Squid Game everywhere that you feel behind, you feel left out if you don't know what they're talking about, if you don't know what the show is about. So that is the power of word of mouth. People are spreading the news so fast and they're having these insider jokes and conversations that if you're not one of them, you feel left out and you feel like you're out of that community. Inside jokes and memes around Squid Game have infiltrated social media platforms. People are talking about it everywhere and people are creating their own content and basically taking off work off of Netflix's marketing team. And why has word of mouth worked so well for Squid Game? I guess it's because the topic is contrarian, twisted, and disturbing. And people want to just talk about it with someone else. People want to share and hear what other people think about the Squid Game and what they've just seen. And all that conversation naturally and organically happening around Squid Game just shows us the unbeatable power of organic marketing and word of mouth. People creating content for your brand is like next level. So what is the marketing takeaway? Can you give opportunities to your audience to create their own content in the context of what you do, not necessarily around your product or service, but in the context of what you do? This obviously depends on what type of business you're in, but two examples could be people taking photos in a photo booth that you set up in your shop or on a main street, or maybe you run a meme competition online where the winner gets a cash prize or another gift. Next is using symbols and specific costumes. So I'm gonna touch upon both of those separately. First one, the Squid Game organizers have a card that has their logo on it. I'm gonna assume it's a logo or a symbol, whatever you wanna call it, but it's basically a triangle, square, and a circle, and I'm not sure if that's the right order, but those are the three shapes that we keep seeing over and over again throughout the show. So people have those shapes on their masks, we see it on the cards, we see it elsewhere as other symbols throughout the show, and those are such easy symbols that our memories can easily pick it up and we can remember and connect to it anywhere else we see those symbols ever again. So this isn't gonna be a good sign, but whenever in the future I see those three shapes side by side, I'm probably going to think about Squid Game. And also it's so easy to draw and replicate as well. So I thought of this way. If the organizers had the logo of an actual squid, it would have been so much harder for people to replicate and copy those symbols on other material like the merchandise or anywhere else. But now, because the symbols are so easy, our memories just instantly pick it up and we're gonna remember it from now on. The other one is the costume. So throughout the show, we only see two main costumes over and over again, which is the green sweatsuits and the red jumpsuits that the killers or the soldiers wear. I don't know what to call them, but we mainly see the green and the red. And that is, again, another symbol as well, because the show starts off with a game that's called Green Light, Red Light. So they're green sweatsuits and red jumpsuits. Anyway, so they are very, again, easy to remember. and easy to recreate into merchandise, which is now what brands are doing. Netflix is already selling hoodies. Walmart is working on or maybe already created costumes. I'm already seeing people recreating the costumes for Halloween as well. So from now on, whenever we see a green sweatsuit or a red jumpsuit, I know that we're all going to think about the Squid Game because it's so easy to remember. And because it's on repeat throughout the show, it just becomes engraved in our memories. So what's the marketing takeaway here? Using symbols or elements that are easy to remember and that can be moved easier to other contexts could be a good tactic to use. It gives people something to copy and remember your brand much easier than something much more complex. Next thing that contributed to the success of the Squid Game is memes, and it's not because Netflix initiated creating memes around Squid Game, but people started to do that on their own. But what I find is that comedy always spreads faster than anything, and it is so easy to create that type of content and spread it. I read that on TikTok, those memes and jokes and GIFs, they have become viral so quickly on TikTok, and that really contributed to the organic reach of the brand and the show. So the marketing takeaway here is to allow some space for comedy and fun in your marketing campaigns and let people have some fun with it. And the final one is to have a goal with your campaigns, but let your audience guide you and be ready for some surprises. Sometimes you're gonna take a fresh perspective, you're gonna disrupt the industry, you're gonna make something very out of the ordinary, and you might have some goals, you might have some expectations, but be ready for some surprises. I'm sure that the Squid Game producers had some goals and some, they were expecting a certain level of impact, but they were probably not expecting this much impact across the world. And they're probably surprised. And sometimes you just have to try something fresh and disruptive and let your audience guide you. And you're gonna look at the data and retention, but they might surprise you. You never know. So that's another marketing lesson that you can take away from the show and from this video as well. So if you watched the show, did you have any other marketing lessons that you want to share with us? Leave it in the comments below. If not, I hope you enjoyed this video and took something away from it. Let me know if you like this type of video, and I'll be motivated to maybe make more videos around marketing lessons from brands, campaigns, other shows, and so on. So let me know in the comments below. And don't forget to give it a like and subscribe to the channel for more videos on marketing and work life. And I'll see you in the next video. Take care, guys. Bye-bye.